One of the things that we know about life is that it is always changing. Sometimes you're up, sometimes you're down. Sometimes things go real well, and sometimes they don't. Sometimes you're happy, and sometimes you're sad. Now that's that thing called life. And when we begin to understand and know that, accepting that reality, that we will never ever have things just on an even keel all the time. That you're gonna have some ups and you're gonna have some downs. But during those down moments, that's where the growth takes place. That's where the work is. Anybody can feel good when they have their health, their bills are paid, they have happy relationships, the children are acting normal. Anybody can be positive then. Anybody can have a larger vision then. Anybody can have faith under those kinds of circumstances. See, but the real challenge of growth, mentally, emotionally, and spiritually, comes when you get knocked down. How you handle it, that's where the growth takes place. What has brought you to this point? What did you learn from it? Are you learning anything? Are you doing it over and over and over again? Are you going through it or are you growing through it? Are you bigger and better because of it? Things are going to happen to you, and the most important thing to do is to harness your will and let it go. I'm in control here. I'm not going to let this get me down. I'm not going to let this destroy me. I'm coming back, and I'll be stronger and better because of it. You have got to make a declaration that this is what you stand for. You're standing up for your dreams. You're standing up for peace of mind. You're standing up for health. You want it, and you're going to go all out to have it. Yes. I'm going to turn this situation around. I'm not going to sit back and moan and cry over what happened and what went wrong and who did what. I'm going to do something about this situation. Expect things to get better for you, because they are. See, life is cyclic. Whatever experience you're having right now, it has not come to stay. It has come to pass.
Imagine you're on your deathbed, and standing around your deathbed are the ghosts representing your unfulfilled potential. The ghost of the ideas you never acted on. The ghost of the talents you didn't use. And they're standing around your bed, angry, disappointed, and upset. They say, we came to you because you could have brought us to life, they say. And now we have to go to the grave together. So I ask you today, how many ghosts are going to be around your bed when your time comes?
In order to do something you've never done, you must be born again. But most people are living like they're living because of the fact that they don't believe they can have any more than what they now have. They accept the reality that they have been given. You have something special. You have talents and abilities in you that you don't even know. First step is you got to live your calling. You got to decide what is it you love.
Don't listen to the naysayers. I mean, how many times have you heard that you can't do this and you can't do that and it has never been done before? Yes, you can.
I want you to think about this goal that you want. I want you to envision it and see it in your mind's eye. And every day say to yourself, I can do this. I can make this happen.
There is no passion to be found playing small and settling for a life that's less than the one you're capable of living. You will fail at some point in your life. Accept it. You will lose. You will embarrass yourself. You will suck at something. There's no doubt about it.
I don't want you to be the next Oprah. I don't want you to be the next Obama. I don't even want you to be the next me. I want you to be you.
But you're going to have some ups and you're going to have some downs. You're going to have people to do things to you. Things are going to happen to you. And the most important thing to do is to harness your will and let it go.
If you don't fail, you're not even trying. Every failed experiment is one step closer to success.
You have to trust in something. Your gut, destiny, life, karma, whatever. Because believing that the dots will connect down the road will give you the confidence to follow your heart, even when it leads you off the well-worn path. And that will make all the difference.
You've got genius in you. You have some special stuff in you. You were born to win.
You want it. And you're going to go all out to have it.
If it's hard, then do it hard. You've got to be willing to do the things today others won't do in order to have the things tomorrow others won't have.
Do you know how powerful you are?
Whatever your gift is, what are you going to do with what you have?
Your freedom and happiness has been restricted by a story that you never double-checked. You never double-checked the narrative with your... You never cross-referenced the narrative that you were fed. You believed it hook, line, and sinker, and now your happiness will be diminished. People in general do not want their belief systems to be challenged. They want to hear things that pump them up. They don't want to be consistently challenged. So the reason why what people often do is they use groupthink in order to save themselves mental energy, and then they parrot back the opinions of the herd because they think that that gets them approval and safety. Literally, the mental prisons that you're initially fed that stifle you down, and then now you are the jailer. You are your own worst enemy. These guys that are like, I don't agree with ever good ghosts are the best. He literally is his own jailer now. He is hurting himself now. It's so crazy. Most people, however, have a very groupthink strategy. The problem with a groupthink strategy is that you have the sheep and the wolves. The wolves eat the sheep. Everybody is willing to pay to be told what to think and what to do. Basically, the wolves are people that are not mentally lazy. If you want to be a wolf in life, you have to be okay with a high degree of uncertainty, ambiguity. Realize that you are in a cultural hypnosis. So the biggest thing that I've realized over the past year, I'd say, because I like to share my biggest epiphanies when I come to Summit of the Year, is the severity of mass cultural hypnosis. It is a lot more severe than I ever really understood. We're all influenced by our social environment. We are not isolated little fucking islands. We are permeable membranes. So what I realized over time, you have to be very controlling of what you choose to let into your headspace, okay? Massively controlling. You have to be aware of what's getting in. Don't let in shit that you have thought through and that you don't want to let in. Okay? So if you want to move ahead in the world, you have to really pull yourself out of easy thinking. Don't look for the easy truths. Some truths are easy. Keep things simple, but never simpler than they actually are. Make it as simple as it can be, but don't make it simpler than it actually is. You have to choose your influences very carefully and choose what am I putting into myself very carefully. Then what you have to do is you have to have a very strong personal boundary of anything that's not moving you in that direction. But to do this, I think, to make it practical and to pull it off, you have to have a reason why you're doing it. There has to be something that motivates you to do that. With increased purpose, it's like your gravity increases and it increases your personal boundaries. Most people's behavior day to day, if you think about it, is coping behavior. They're just trying to cope. They don't feel great and they're just trying to fucking cope. Assume failure. Assume that you will be a failure. Assume that failure is the default unless you fix it. You have to be on top of your shit. Every minute that goes by, if you're on a life mission, you're going by, it's not happening, you're losing time. This is not up for debate, you're losing time. If you'd use the time better, you could have done more. If you use the time worse, you could do less. Think of a mission. Think of the fucking higher universal values that you would have to embody to accomplish it, and just spend your time moving in that direction. Think bigger, bigger thoughts. What I realized what was satisfying to me was finding higher values and the struggle and journey of embodying those values. That's where I really found happiness.
We have our dreams, our passion for a reason. It is not by chance. Whatever vision you have for yourself, somehow you've been gifted with this inner voice, this spectacular talent and potential that's never ending. And most people never live up to that. Understand that what has been given to you has been given to you particularly, specifically, for a reason. You're one of a kind. You're something special. Don't cheat yourself out of that by living an average life. Life is hard, yeah, that's right. You're gonna experience some struggles, some pain, some hardships. But it's not about what happens to you. Because these things, whether you believe it or not, happen to everyone. But it's the way that you respond to these things that really makes you stand out. That's what makes a difference. You will never be able to control everyone and everything around you. You can't always choose what happens, but you can choose what you are going to do about it. That's fully and entirely up to you. Most people will make excuses, but if you want things to go your way, take full responsibility. Because that means you have the power to change it. It's up to you to make a difference. The power is in your hands. Think about that for a second. That's all the power you need, the ability to impact and change anything. It's up to you. You have to switch out of that pity victim mentality and never look back. What gives your life meaning? What gives it purpose? What drives you? The voices in your head telling you that you are not good enough, that you can't make it happen, as well as maybe even the people around you saying those things. It has to stop. It has to end. That's not good enough. That's not good enough. You have to do better than that. You have to step up with some power. Make a statement to the universe. I am capable. I am powerful. I not only can, but I will make it happen. Only you can claim your own power. Nobody else can do that for you. You're designing your own future right now. You're crafting. You're creating right now. You're making your own experience. There are some abilities, some talents, some gifts you have that absolutely no one else can tap into except for you.
Fighting change is a losing battle. Freedom and happiness are found in the flexibility and ease with which we move through change. And obviously, I can't stress how important this is. So I want to start off by bringing your attention to a natural human trait, and that is that we love comfort. Human beings are creatures of habit. We love comfort, predictability, stability, you know, just things remaining the same, just being able to relax, you know, like no surprises. You know, we love that, and we love it too much. You know, what the fuck's wrong with loving comfort too much? And therein lies the problem and the source of a lot of frustration and unhappiness for a lot of people. Now, why is that? You need things like discomfort, unpredictability, you know, things to be changing in order to grow and become more anti-fragile of a person. The main reason is simply the fact that in this world, nothing is stable. Okay, everything is constantly changing. And that's the natural course of life. As human beings, you know, we're creatures of habit, you know. We like comfort, we like, you know, things to remain the same. We really, really hate change, you know, like anything that's, you know, chaotic or, you know, the unknown. And if you look at your life situation now, okay, like just really think of it, like where you are in life, and you go back a year or two, I doubt that it was very different. Okay, unless you've already been taking tons of action, it's probably the same, okay, or very similar. It's like you might have a new, you know, promotion, you might be a little ahead, say, if you're going to university or something, but, you know, you're probably the same person, okay? It's like you haven't changed much, and it's just gonna keep going that way, okay? It's not going to get better. And what I want to address today are a series of excuses that I hear all the time. I'm not in the mood, you know, I just don't feel like it. I don't have the energy, you know, I'm just tired. You know what, I think I need to read more theory about this, you know, before kind of like mastering this, you know, achieving success. And basically all these excuses here, you know, are just blaming the current circumstances. You know, it's like, I would do it, but the current circumstances really don't allow it. So it's not really my fault, it's just that, you know, the circumstances suck. Okay, and this frame of mind here, okay, this is what you truly believe, and you're just blaming the circumstances, is going to hold you back, and ultimately, trust me when you hear me say this, you will never achieve any fucking type of success. So there are a couple things you need to realize, you know, when it comes to your circumstances. The first one is that your circumstances are rarely going to get any better, okay, and this is very important to understand. It's not going to get better, okay? And in reality, it's often going to get worse, okay? If your excuse is, you know what, I'm a little tired, getting older, it's not gonna get better. You're gonna get even more tired, okay? If you don't have time now, the older you get, the more responsibility you're taking on, you're gonna have a lot less time too. So remember this, circumstances rarely get any better, and oftentimes they just get worse. And with a lot of these excuses as well, realize that it's the other way around. Okay, like if you're waiting to feel motivated, you know, like, you know what, I'm just not in the mood, and I'm gonna wait till I feel in the mood, you know, to take action, realize that that there is rarely going to happen, since this here is a new, you know, habit, a new skill set. You're not really gonna feel motivated. Why? Because as we discussed before, human beings are creatures of habit. Okay. You're used to your little routine. This here is something new, something that creates a little bit more chaos. Your emotions are going to be like, you know what? You're going to feel motivated to create some chaos in your life. You're going to be like, no, it's just, my emotions are just not aligned. They're just not there yet. Okay? That there is normal. So it's the other way around. Okay? Don't wait to feel motivated. Just force yourself to take on this new habit, you know, going out, taking action. And by doing that, okay, it's going to start feeling a little bit more comfortable, and the motivation is going to start, you know, coming after that. Okay, it's like you take action, the motivation comes. It's not, I'm waiting to feel motivated to take action. Don't depend on your circumstances. Don't wait for them to change or miraculously get better. Don't wait till you're in the mood. It's just basically start fucking now. Okay, start now, and all those things will ultimately just take care of themselves. Try to find a nice middle ground where instead of focusing all your energy on maintaining things, as they are, focus instead on navigating through that change in a way that's beneficial to you. Remember, indirect control, focus on the bigger picture, and fighting change is a losing battle. Freedom and happiness are found in the flexibility and ease with which we move through change. Work on that.
That any of us have dreams that were not given to us for the purpose of accomplishing those particular dreams.
If you feel you have something to give, if you feel that your particular talent is worth developing, is worth caring for, then there's nothing you can't achieve.
So I applaud you for your dreaming. For your running toward your dream, I applaud you for believing in yourself, because that's what life is about, stretching and challenging, looking for ways that you can begin to improve yourself. Not only is it possible for you to have your dream, but it's necessary that you go for what is yours in the universe. Logical, practical thinking says you can't do it today. But if you want to produce unreasonable results in your life, like living your dream and taking charge of your destiny, you've got to be an unreasonable person.
When you grow up, you tend to get told that the world is the way it is. Your life is just to live your life inside the world, try not to bash into the walls too much. That's a very limited life. Life can be much broader. Once you discover one simple fact, everything around you that you call life was made up by people that were no smarter than you. Once you learn that, you'll never be the same again.
If it's hard, why do people do it? Why do they do it? People who climb mountains. Why would a Nelson Mandela give up 26 years of his life? Why do people do that? Even though it's hard, it's worth it. It's worth it. The people who go after this stuff, what makes it worth it? It's got to be your passion. You got to love it. It's got to be what you are supposed to do. You do what it is you're supposed to. You're supposed to build something. You're supposed to create something. I don't know how to do it. Learn. Let me share something with you. History is being read, but it's also being written by people with imagination.
Don't stop. Don't stop. Stop running toward your dream.
Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us.
Nope. Nope. Right. I'm just gonna have to.
No matter how bad it is, or how bad it gets, I'm going to make it. Live your life with passion. With some drive.
Man is the master of thought, the molder of character, and the maker and shaper of condition, environment, and destiny.
Most men fail, not through lack of education or agreeable personal qualities, but from lack of dogged determination, from lack of dauntless will.
Situations, even dramatic situations like bankruptcy, divorce, death, and economic recession, cannot directly cause a feeling of any kind until the brain interprets and creates a story about said situation. Sadness, depression, frustration, upset, and anxiety can only be produced by seeing a situation and then producing an interpretation of it, and then believing that interpretation. So therefore, you and I can only be overwhelmed by our thoughts about something.
How can
never
I go about
thing
this?
Itself.
I think, is it streaming okay?
Usually, what we most fear doing is what we most need to do. That phone call, that conversation, whatever the action might be, it is fear of unknown outcomes that prevents us from doing what we need to do.
Define the worst case,
accept it, and do it. I'll repeat something you might consider tattooing on your forehead. What we fear doing most is usually what we most need to do.
I don't get lucky. I make my own luck.
Every journey ends, but we go on. The world turns and we turn with it. Plans disappear. Dreams take over.
Here's the big challenge of life. You can have more than you've got because you can become more than you are. And of course, the other side of the coin reads, unless you change how you are, you'll always have what you got. Success is something you attract, not something you pursue. Success is looking for a good place to stay. So instead of going after it, you work on yourself. Personal development.
See, one of the challenges that we have in our lives is we don't realize that the process of training ourselves, the process of conditioning ourselves, actually feels incredible once you get that initial momentum. If you want lasting change, you've got to give up this idea of trying something. You gotta decide you're gonna commit to master it.
See, most people don't get out in the arena of life because they don't want to fight. Most people don't get out there because they don't want to get knocked down. They don't want to be dropped to their knees. But see, you're gonna be dropped whether you're on the field or whether or not you're sitting on the sidelines. You're gonna be dropped. Get knocked down so you can learn how to fight, so you can hold your position.
The last 6,000 years reads like this: opportunity mixed with difficulty. That's how it reads. It isn't going to change. You must learn to handle the nights. They come right after days. You must learn to handle difficulty. It comes right after opportunity. You must learn to handle recessions. They always follow progressions. Don't wish it was easier. Wish you were better.
Clarity is power. The more clear you are about exactly what it is you want, the more your brain knows how to get there. Your reasons will drive you. When you have doubt, when your faith becomes weak, your reasons will fortify your faith. When you have an inner conversation, say, no, don't do that. Your reasons will become your rod and your staff to comfort you, to take you through those challenging moments.
Life is this. I like this.
Approval, what will happen is that you will lose your nerve.
and other people will convince you that what you're doing doesn't have any value, and you'll give up on your dream. We go through life trying to seek security and not coming outside of our comfort zone, and we take most of our stuff with us to the grave. In life, you're either here today and you're gone today. And I'm saying that the fact that you're still here, that you're still breathing, you've got some more work, and you owe it to yourself. You owe it to yourself. So when you get up in the morning, that you can look yourself in the face and say, hey, I'm living my life on my terms. See, if you don't decide to act on your dream, if you don't decide to make a decision to live your life, if you don't decide to step into your fears, if you don't decide to say yes to your life, it will never work for you. Many of us never realize our greatness because we become sidetracked by secondary activity. We spread ourselves too thin, don't know how to say no. And we find ourselves doing all kinds of things and never ever have time to do those things that we need to do to work on ourselves. And then there goes a second, there goes another second, there goes another second, and we can't stop and hold time. And before you know it, you wake up one day and you're behind in your dreams and your bills. Ask your question, how much time do you have left? How much time do you have left? Decide that you're going to take some time to work on you, that you deserve that from yourself, that your life deserves. It's very important. You owe that to yourself. One idea can change your life. One idea can turn your life around. And as you convince you, as you sell yourself, every day, something happens for you. It will enable you to transcend yourself. Wherever you are, whatever you're doing, do it with everything that you have. Develop the habit of giving more than what you're paid for. If there's something that you want and you're hungry for it, you've got to do whatever is necessary until. And when you give the best you can and that's not enough, you must do what is required. When you're hungry, you don't care about the facts. You don't care about the odds. When you step into your fears and continue to push yourself to go on, you begin to see things that have been standing there looking you in the face saying, I can't believe this has been here all this time.
It's supposed to be difficult. If it wasn't difficult, then there'd be no growth. There would be no resistance. There'd be nothing to force you to grow stronger with. And that's why I say the most important reason, the most important thing, the most important gift that you receive by taking action, it's you growing stronger and becoming a stronger version of yourself through the challenges, through the resistance, and because it's hard.
And don't give up on yourself. Don't throw the towel in so quickly. Many people give up on the 1 yard line.
I want you to get to a place in your life that every mistake you make, every setback you get, right, every obstacle that you don't that you don't overcome, every barrier you can't climb, I don't want you to give up, but I want you to fail forward. Every mistake you make has to be another stepping stone, another building block.
And you've got to learn how to tune out the critics outside and the critic inside. And says, I'm going to do this. I'm going to harness my will. And I'm not going to let anything stop me. I deserve this. See, the last chapter to your life has not been written yet. And it doesn't matter about what happened yesterday.
We don't give up. We don't surrender. We don't quit. We think differently. Our perspective is different. And because our perspective is different, our outcomes are different. Our rewards are different.
Embrace the stress. Learning is only there when you when you're in a situation that is super, super stressful for you. So I have to put myself continuously in the situations where I'm under high pressure, because only then I will learn a lot. And the fact that I learn is good, which means high stress is good as well. The reframe that I always have is, the moment I feel resistance, where I'm like coming up with excuses, I know I have to do it. It's a rule of mine. The moment I feel that resistance, the rule kicks in, max there is resistance, now you gotta do it. And if I hesitate, even more reason to do it. Even if I fuck it up, I learn a lot more, because it's a high pressure situation. And even if I don't feel ready, I remember I didn't feel ready at first either, but I still made it. I'm alive, it's all still there, my heart's still pumping, I'm not dead. Don't think yourself like, oh, when I lose, I'm less of a man. No. Is how you deal with it, how you cope with it. It is your attitude towards that. Because it's basically just your body telling you this is a situation that counts. So it's about the attitude that you have towards that. Losing gets you to the fucking top. But you have to get up again. You have to get up again. Fall down 7 times, get up 8 times. Fall down 8 times, get up 9 times. And so on, and so on. You have to trust yourself, and you have to trust the process, that no matter what crisis is going to be thrown at you, have the knowledge that at first you will be overwhelmed and you think you can't do it, but also have the trust kick in, okay, I've dealt with other crises before, no reason why I couldn't deal with that crisis. So, first of all, the thing about crisis is, you never feel ready for one, otherwise it wouldn't be a crisis. You never feel ready, you always think like, that's the worst crisis I've ever been in, but you will grow into that. You will grow into that role of coping with the crisis. There's a lot of shit you have to dig through. And the cool thing is, the more crisis you find yourself in, the more you can cope with the next one. Trusting yourself. But the thing is, you have to accept it first. There's two ways how to deal with a crisis. You either accept it because you can't change it at the moment, or you can change it and then you do fucking change it. Experience pain because you're in a situation that you can't change. Accept that pain fully, like literally, like soak the pain up and walk into the pain. Keep walking until there is no more pain. Every crisis is something good because it gives you the opportunity to grow out of that and to trust yourself more.
So I know it's hard, and I know you seek the results that you had before, but as long as you just trust the process and keep going, you will eventually overcome that. Even though you might not see it in the results yet, even though it might not be manifested in the results, your learning process is there. You do pick up on little nuances that eventually will end up in you getting better. Okay, runner analogy, don't stop, just keep going and trust the process. Get back that excitement of the beginning. Pat yourself on the shoulder, this is awesome. Stop comparing yourself. Shift your focus from comparing to results to comparing the learning process. Am I learning more today? Yes or no? You gotta keep going. You have to, don't stop. Just don't fucking stop. Don't fucking stop doing it. Dude, you have to step your shit up. You have to be active now. Instead of bursting your energy of anger just out there uncontrollably, you gotta collect that anger together to one, very focused on a grade, onto something positive, okay? Anger is not something bad. Anger is something healthy. Use it as leverage. Oh, I'm angry at myself because, again, I'm frustrated. I can't get myself out of the situation. This has to stop now. I'm going to study even harder. I'm going to run even faster. I'm going to try even harder to get that girl. I'm going to use it as leverage because my anger is energy, and that energy can be used for something useful. Don't interpret a stressful situation as something you have to get out of yourself. No. See it as a positive challenge that you can overcome eventually. It goes along with the notion of trusting yourself, trusting your capabilities, and that is what you should do. Okay, anger is something good. Use it as leverage, and use it for something purposeful. Bundle it up together, and rock it.
It's like you don't take life too seriously, but you also have to take your progress seriously. Because if you do not, then you'll wake up in a couple years from now and you'll be just where you are now. Just exactly where you are now.
So your life will blow by faster than you realize. It's super, super fast. Right now, a year passes for me, feels like a week. That's how it feels. Years will blow by. 4 years from now will seem like nothing, dude. And you'll either be a pimp, chode. Dude, anything that of real significance takes years to cultivate. But what's cool is that the years blow by fast and you can get what you want actually pretty fast. Our minds are filled with, again, we're contrasting ourselves against people, comparing ourselves, rather than just getting into momentum. You shouldn't be thinking. People are thinking too fucking much. Or they're comparing themselves to other people as if by comparing yourself, that matters. What does it matter? They're mentally fucking lazy. People, Tony Robbins, people major in minor things. Turn off the fucking TV. News and shit is a goddamn fucking tabloid. What help has any of that shit given you? Dude, like, you have to train your mind to be like, okay, new task. Look at the task. Focus on it. I work fucking hard, dude. Everybody that I see working is, in my mind, fucking pussies. Holy shit. People don't work, dude. It's so crazy how little people work. People go to work for 8 hours. It's like 2 hours. What are they doing? I watch people work. What is he doing? Why is he here? Go run in the field, motherfucker. Don't just sit here. Go run. Play. Don't sit here in this weird gray zone between working and not working. What are you doing? I'm self-hypnotized for two things. Hard fucking work and being fucking funny. So because of that, work ethic is built, right? So it's like an endurance race. So the thing is, like, you build that up. That's why, like, I love these guys that are like, you crying to me, you're getting bad, man. Oh shit, I'm like, no, you're a pussy. You want to keep being a pussy and then have easy money given to you. People just don't fucking work. They have no work ethic. I never meet anybody with fucking work ethic. Like, rarely. When I do, I'm like, yo, high five, dude. And then we're like instantly friends. Because almost nobody has a work ethic. It's so crazy. I'm having as much fun working as I do fucking around. You guys see that? There's no difference to me. I don't care if I'm working, if I'm having fun. Recreation is overrated. People think you need to be having recreation to have fun. You don't. I can't have fun working? Why not? It's your attitude towards the work. Now, sometimes work can be tough. I get that. It can be miserable. It can be soul-sucking. But in general, it's mental strength. You choose to have fun because you have no mental muscle that chooses to have fun at that point. It's like, what could be possible after 10 years? Like, start thinking like that. Like, what could I look like in 10 years? What could I look like in 20 years? What could I look like in 30 years? If you're 20, you should be thinking, what could you look like in 30 years? What could your life look like? And I realized that I need to surround myself with winners. I need to surround myself with people that are killing it and crushing it at life. I need to surround myself with people that hold me to higher standards. I need to read books and control my influences. And I'm very careful about what influences I allow into myself. Very, very selective about what people I allow around myself. If people are acting up, I get rid of them. You gotta do it, man. The iron gate, baby. Personal boundaries. Shut. The iron gate. Personal boundaries, any bullshit. Shut. And as you grow, you'll have to do that to more and more things. See, growing is about saying no to more and more things. You say no to bullshit little tabloid pretending to be media. You say no to friends that are negative. You say no to procrastination. You say no to approaching anxiety of a woman. You say no to holding yourself to the lowest standards. You just say fucking no.
It takes guts. You gotta dig down deep to gut it out. Keep on going again and again and again until you make it happen because you know that it's possible. Now, what do you do during the hard times, Les? Here's what you must do. Number one is, you must have faith. Paul said you must have the faith to call forth those things that be not as though they were. Judge not according to appearances. Don't judge your circumstances and the possibilities for your future based upon what you have now and because of what's going on now. No, 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 no.
That's not the real reality there. What you're going through, if you're going through some hard times, it has not come to stay. It has come to pass. It's all right. Now, second thing is, repeat this after me. Something you should affirm to yourself every day. Repeat this, please. No matter how bad it is, or how bad it gets, I'm going to make it. Say that to yourself every day. As I used to say to myself, when I would get up in the Penobscot building and I had to go into the bathroom and bathe in the bathroom sink, I had written on the mirror that I put up, they just pasted up and I read, no matter how bad it is or how bad it gets, I'm going to make it. So you've got to have faith, you talk to yourself, you say that affirmation. The next step is you must have patience and engage in consistent action. Patience and engage in consistent action. See, everything does not always happen, ladies and gentlemen, when we want it to happen. It doesn't happen quickly. So in that process, they have something in the Far East called the Chinese bamboo tree. The Chinese bamboo tree, every day it has to be watered and fertilized. It's a very hard nut, and it takes 5 years of watering and fertilization every day, according to American Geographic, before it breaks through the ground. At any time, if the watering process and the nurturing and the fertilization process is stopped, the Chinese bamboo tree will die in the ground. Now, once it breaks through in that fifth year, then in 6 weeks it grows 90 feet tall. Now, the question is, does it grow 90 feet in 5 years or 6 weeks? The answer is obvious. It takes 5 years. That's how long it took to grow it, to build that foundation, to nurture it, to water it, to build the reputation, to build the credibility, to learn the market, to learn people, to learn yourself, to learn the system, to learn how to do it, to figure it out. That's why you must have patience and engage in consistent action. We live in a world, ladies and gentlemen, where people want instant gratification. They want it right now. They want to be a Dexter Yeager, but they're not willing to pay the price to do what it takes to get up there with Dick Hopper. Or Bryant or Judy. They think it was easy. No, no. It's simple, but it's not easy. It's a system that if you work the system, it works if you work it. But make no mistake about it. It's hard. You are the determining factor. Here's something else. It's possible you can live your dream. It's necessary that you have goals, that you write them down, that you surround yourself with a support team, that you are creative. It's you that you must take personal responsibility to make it happen. George Bernard Shaw said, the people that make it in this world look around for the circumstances that they want, and if they can't find them, they create them. It's hard. No, easy is not an option. However, ladies and gentlemen, what you will discover is that it's worth it. It's worth it. I suggest to you, if you want to become diamond, write down 5 reasons of why it is worth it for you to become a diamond, to experience that level of achievement. What is it that will give you the drive? What is it that will ignite the courage in you to get up and come back again and again and again? How is it that you would be able, what reasons that can tap in to that deep down feeling that goes to your gut, that no matter how many times you get knocked down, that you're coming back? What is it? Write it down. Let me tell you something, ladies and gentlemen. You saw that picture up there, the lady, Mrs. Mamie Brown. I'm flying from here tomorrow morning to be with my adopted mother. She's 87 years young, thank God. Now I'll be with Mama tomorrow. Every
Mother's Day, I don't care where I am. I go home Mother's Day, everybody knows, November 6th, my mother's birthday, I'm home. And I try to go home as often as I can. When I started and left Miami pursuing my dream, because I knew that as long as you work for someone else, they are controlling your destiny. I don't want anybody signing my paycheck but me. I knew that it was going to be difficult. I knew it was going to be hard. But every time I thought about giving up, and there were times I did, because where I am, ladies and gentlemen, it's a long shot. You think being a diamond is a long shot. This is a miracle. This is a long shot. And I had people laughing at me. Les, you're talking about being a motivational speaker? You have no college training. You were labeled educable, mentally retarded. You failed twice in school. They put you back from the fifth grade into the fourth grade, and you fail in the eighth grade. You've never worked for a major corporation, and you are going to become independently wealthy. Right. They laugh. They're going to laugh at you. People are going to laugh at you. But let me tell you, I believe in revenge like Frank Sinatra. He said the best revenge is massive success. Ladies and gentlemen, when I was driving around with my mother and she saw a house, we were just looking for homes and we drove an exclusive area of Miami where the coach of the Miami Dolphins, Don Shula, lives in that area called Country Club. My mother saw this house. Oh, that's what a beautiful home. And we looked at it. She said, oh boy, I would love to have something like that. One day I would feel like Mrs. Rock. I said, you like that, Mom? I said, yeah. I said, oh, we just kept driving. I did not let my mother know at that time that I had it etched in my mind that I was going to do whatever number of meetings, whatever number of contacts, whatever number of calls I had to make, whatever it took to make that become a reality. And the day that I drove to that house and said, Mama, you remember that house you saw? We got out the car. I said, yes. I said, I really know the people that live there. She said, you do? I said, yeah, let me take you in and show it to you. And then I couldn't contain myself anymore when I got around and helped her get out of the car. And I took it. I said, Mom, I gave her the keys. Over 5,000 square feet. Large size Olympic pool, 12 feet deep. On a golf course, basketball court. I said, Mama, this is for you. And ladies and gentlemen, to see my mother walk around this house. This woman, who only has a third grade education, never had any children of her own. And she walked around. She said, oh, Lord. Oh, thank you, Jesus. No one would have ever told me this would have happened to me. She said, Leslie, she said, you know, that day when I went in that building and they told me this lady had these boys that she wanted to put up for adoption. And I told them, I said, I'll take them. And she said, ladies, she said, raise your hand and swear to me two things. I said, what is it? She said, swear to me you won't separate them. She said, oh, no, I swear. I'll keep them together. I swear. I've never had no children. I swear I'll keep them together. She said, swear to me, lady, that you won't ever tell them about me. She said, I married and I got pregnant while my husband was at war. She said, swear to me you won't tell. She said, I swear I won't tell. She said, okay. You can have them. She said, when I came out the house, I was looking at y'all. She said, I didn't know how I was going to do it. She said, I was working at the M&M cafeteria. She said, I didn't know how I was going to raise y'all. I just knew somehow the Lord would make a way somehow. And I never thought this would happen to me. I know. And during those moments when it's hard, not only must you have patience and engage in consistent action, but you must turn to a power greater than yourself and just say, Lord, whatever I face today together, you and I can handle it. And I know some way and somehow you'll make a way for me.
Every passing minute is another chance to turn it all around.
Never believe a prediction that doesn't empower you. How many predictions have been thrown at you your whole life? If you believe predictions that do not empower you, you will wither away and die. Either physically die or your spirit will die as you just walk around the world like a carcass that is just following the masses. You will be given a lot of titles in your life. You will be told so many different things. You must only listen to that which empowers you.
See, it's not important how long you live. What's important is how you live.
The first thing I believe you gotta do to turn yourself around is really take control of your mind. Or specifically, you gotta feed and strengthen the mind.
Guess what? You're gonna make some mistakes. So the person who's never made a mistake hasn't done anything. If you're going to make some mistakes, if you want to do something out here, you're going to fall flat on your face. You're going to be criticized when you come out into the arena called life. You're going to feel awkward and stupid and dumb sometimes. It goes with the territory. But it's okay.
Take charge of your own life. Then walk away from the 95%. Don't go where they go. Don't do what they do. Don't talk like they talk. Develop you a whole new language. Don't use their vocabulary. Don't use their excuses. Once you look back on it, you will never turn back. You'll never go back to the old ways and the old language and the old neglect. Never.
Day trying to be a little wiser than you were when you woke up. Discharge your duties faithfully and well. Step by step you get ahead, but not necessarily in fast spurts. But you build discipline by preparing for fast spurts. Slug it out one inch at a time, day by day. And at the end of the day, if you live long enough, most people get what they deserve. Short-term temporal pleasure, but here's the problem with that. Things are good for a sec, and then they're not. And then things feel good for a sec, and then they're not, right? You smoke the joint, you're high, and then you're not. You know what I'm saying, right? You're watching fucking American Idol, and then you're not. So your happiness is too shaky. Life is difficult for people that come from a fucked up background. I think the same shit, but you can overcome it. So the main difference that I have is I realistically assess it, and I'm in non-resistance to it. I'm at a point where I wouldn't want it any other way. Pretty much then what you do is you limit your emotions down to only the ones that will help you, okay? So if you have an emotion that doesn't help you, you just get rid of it. It's gone.
What I feel like what happens is like there's these forces that push down upon us. They push down upon our psyche. And when we can rise above those, that's like the most powerful experience of life. I think a lot of people sense that beneath all this bullshit, there's these deeper values that are more powerful than any of this surface level bullshit that resonate with people more powerfully.
You're grounded in your own energy. You're on your purpose. So you're going to do what you're going to do. It's like this train's moving. And then you're free. Like you're very uninhibited.
The last thing on this earth that you're feeling
when you've conquered your fears and conquered your obstacles.
It's like, what's that guy look like? Does he have a nicer nose than me? Does he have better calves?
It's insane. If I'm gonna get what I want, I've gotta just do it. Just shut the fuck up and let's fucking get on with it. So when I go in there, I just do it, all right? I shut the fuck up and I do it. If you're gonna fucking do it, then fucking do it. Let's get on with it. When you're at the top of a building, you're walking along a ledge, you can sit there going, what if I fall? What if I fall? What if I fall? Or you can say, put 1 foot here, put 1 foot here, put 1 foot here, put 1 foot here. What I would love you to do is to become a man on your purpose. Become so immersed in the movement of your life that you don't have time to let these mind viruses invade your head and spend all this time entertaining them. Get rid of it. Get rid of your mending. Enjoy your life. Assume that you chose this life. When you do that, you're going to open up a whole new range of possibility to yourself. You're going to start enjoying walking your own journey, and you're going to let the chips fall where they may. When you're happy with the person who you become, that is always the payoff.
All you have to do is just go to the Eaton Center, walk around, feel sorry for yourself, but when you go home, you can lose yourself in infinite hours of torrented TV shows and torrented movies. And when you're on your deathbed, you look back, all your friendships, they're all actors. They're all fictional little characters. But you don't care. You had a lot of friends. And that's a lot of people nowadays. They go through their shitty job, they feel like they don't have much of a purpose, they're not very significant in life. It's like, oh man, I just need to feel sorry for myself a few more minutes before I pass out, and then I'll dream that I'm in Game of Thrones, and my life will be better again. The more you stay at home, the more you stay in that cycle, the more, let's just say, the harder it is to snap out of that cycle. Okay, you slowly start losing willpower, and then what happens? If that's you, and you want to get good at this, as I mentioned before, something fun is not going to snap you out of that. If you have zero willpower, and your life is a complete piece of shit, something fun, you want to change that shit, life or death. Go all out. In terms of motivation, you better be fucking serious. Good enough, not good enough. Okay? Something fun, not good enough. Life or fucking death. You always know deep down inside you can be better.
So you really have to move from failure consciousness to success consciousness. Okay, now what does that mean? Basically, focus also on the positive. You know, find ways to give yourself props. Ask yourself, you know, what did I do well? You know, I went in with good intentions. You know, I did this well, I did this well. Like, just start making that fucking shift.
You have to get addicted to this slow progress, building shit the right way. It's like little increments of 1%, 1%, 1%. And then you look back, say 3 to 6 months, you actually see the change. Get addicted to that. Be happy with that. Life is a journey, not a destination. Okay, the fun here is in the process. The fun is getting a little bit better, a little bit better, a little bit better. Do it like a video game. Once you realize, as previously discussed, you're in this for life. Okay, it's not a little sprint where you try to get good fast. It's a fucking marathon. It's important to understand that, but it's also important to prepare for it, okay, both mentally and physically. Just keep moving forward, okay? Don't stop to celebrate the good. Don't stop to celebrate the bad. You don't have time to celebrate. Just keep fucking going. So on the mental preparation side of things, this really means sitting down. You know, you're watching this video. Sit down if you're watching this video and ask yourself these questions, okay? Are you really willing to commit to this, you know, the rest of your life? Like, is this something, like a path you're going to walk, you know, till the day that you die? Because this is not an easy path. Okay? The easy path is just slacking off and doing nothing. Now, it's not the path that's going to bring you happiness and fulfillment, but that's the easy way out. Okay? This shit here means holding yourself at a high standard. It means continuously putting yourself in situations that make you grow, situations that are not necessarily comfortable. It's emotionally traumatizing. You're going to have to go through a lot of humiliation, okay, stuff, you know, moments of embarrassing yourself. You're going to have to tolerate a lot of social pressure. You're going to have to let your ego just leave it at the door. You know, let go of that little ego. Just really put yourself, you know, on the line. You're going to have to go through failure, rejection. There's a lot of bullshit involved.
And you have to sit down now and ask yourself, like, am I going to do this? Am I really ready to commit to this? Am I going to hold myself to a high standard? Am I going to be the best that I can be? Am I ready for all the bullshit that I'm going to encounter? Am I ready to just let go of comfort, let go of stability, let go of predictability? Am I ready to possibly cut off some friends? Let go of my reputation? To what degree are you prepared? Are you prepared to dedicate yourself to this task? You have to take it seriously. How bad do you want it? Do you have enough leverage? This is something you just can't live without doing, without achieving. What are you willing to give in return? Okay, nothing comes for free. It's not an easy task. What are you willing to give in return? Fuck your ego. Fuck your current identity. Let that go. You know? Fuck comfort. You gotta be a little crazy to do this all the way. You gotta fuck comfort. Emotional trauma. Like, what are you willing to give? Okay, sit down and ask yourself these questions. I ask myself these questions every single fucking day. And when I wake up, I'm like, okay, let's remind yourself. Again, it's a marathon. You gotta be prepared.
So this one's a quite interesting topic. It's about change. The powerful path to self-fulfillment. A really, really important question that I asked myself when I started my journey was, where does change actually begin? Does it begin with the actions I take? Does it begin with results? Does it begin with other people noticing that I changed, that I got somewhere, that I have results or whatever? If you want to change, this change begins by the way you communicate with yourself. So by the way we communicate, we create reality. These are four phases of changing. Okay, number one is, I should change. And the really, really sad part about this is 99.9% of people who are living on this planet are being stuck in the first stage. There's literally people who will spend the rest of their life doing nothing more but saying, I should change. And after 80, 90 years, they're dying thinking of, I should have changed. And that's really sad. So how can you overcome that? It starts in your communication. It starts in your thoughts. You want to get to the next stage, which is, I can change. Once you realize the fact that change is possible, it will open up a lot more possibilities. Okay? Stage two, I can change. Now what gets you to the next level? You take action, aka I will change. Okay? So the only thing that you need in order to get from step two, I can change, to step three, I will change, is taking action. So you realize you're able to change. Now is the time to get off your lazy ass and take action. Now is the time to go out and pimp. Now is the time to get butt hurt, to get rejected. Now is the time to hit the gym. Now is the time to read everything about finance. Okay? Take action. I will change. Feels good. Sounds good, huh? I will change. It's not like, well, I should change at some point. No, it's like, I will change. And the cool thing is, feels good, feels awesome, taking action. And the last thing we actually arrive at is, I am change. And that's literally one of the best feelings in the world. Back in the days, fucking thousands of years ago, we were not taught to be passive. We were taught to be active, to go out and hunt, to get food, to survive. We're literally one of the first generations that is being taught how to be passive and how to cope with shit. That's like our default state for humanity is, I mean, I guess because we're having all this luxus and like all this, you know, we don't have to hunt for our food. We can pretty much tell that if we go outside, there's no fucking tiger killing us. So we have all the security, and I think that's why we're so passive. That's why we're brought up waiting for changes. Fuck your passivity. Fuck it. In order to change, you have to be active. You will never bring change if you're passive. And that's what literally everyone does. We're all waiting for change. We're like sitting there like, maybe someone comes across and helps me. Instead, you have to be active in order to change. It's not over until you win. Stop being passive. It's not over until you win. It doesn't work? What will fix it? Taking action. It's not easy. I'm not saying it's easy, but I'm saying it's possible. That's all you need. And the crazy thing is, like I mentioned earlier, most of us will keep waiting for changes and we're gonna die. And most of you guys, that's the truth, okay? That's the very uncomfortable truth. Most of you guys will come home and will not change. You'll come home with all the knowledge today, maybe some motivation, but you will not change because in your headspace, you're thinking, well, change will come upon myself. But the only thing that will bring change upon yourself is you yourself, okay? By taking action. You can't wait for change. You have to induce the change yourself. It can show you the right path or the right door you can walk through, but you have to be on that path yourself with your fucking feet. You have to walk through that door yourself. The only one who brings change upon yourself is you. No one else. And yes, it feels uncomfortable, and yes, you'll have a lot of setbacks and a lot of rejections that will hurt. But if you endure that pain, you can make it. It will feel awesome. Let me tell you that. It feels fucking awesome. What do you want? It's as simple as that. Key to happiness, the key to an amazing life full of adventures, of fulfilling your dreams, is what do you want? It's not over until I win.
I don't want to be an emperor. That's not my business. I don't want to rule or conquer anyone. I should like to help everyone if possible. Jew, Gentile, black man, white. We all want to help one another. Human beings are like that. We want to live by each other's happiness, not by each other's misery. We don't want to hate and despise one another. In this world, there's room for everyone, and the good earth is rich and can provide for everyone. The way of life can be free and beautiful. But we have lost the way. Greed has poisoned men's souls, has barricaded the world with hate, has goose-stepped us into misery and bloodshed. We have developed speed, but we have shut ourselves in. Machinery that gives abundance has left us in want. Our knowledge has made us cynical, our cleverness hard and unkind. We think too much and feel too little. More than machinery, we need humanity. More than cleverness, we need kindness and gentleness. Without these qualities, life will be violent, and all will be lost. The aeroplane and the radio have brought us closer together. The very nature of these inventions cries out for the goodness in men, cries out for universal brotherhood, for the unity of us all. Even now, my voice is reaching millions throughout the world, millions of despairing men, women, and little children, victims of a system that makes men torture and imprison innocent people. To those who can hear me, I say, do not despair. The misery that is now upon us is but the passing of greed, the bitterness of men who fear the way of human progress. The hate of men will pass, and dictators die, and the power they took from the people will return to the people. And so long as men die, liberty will never perish. Soldiers, don't give yourselves to brutes. Men who despise you, enslave you, who regiment your lives, tell you what to do, what to think, and what to feel, who drill you, diet you, treat you like cattle, use you as cannon fodder. Don't give yourselves to these unnatural men, machine men with machine minds and machine hearts. You are not machines. You are not cattle. You are men. You have the love of humanity in your hearts. You don't hate. Only the unloved hate.
the unloved and the unnatural. Soldiers, don't fight for slavery, fight for liberty. In the 17th chapter of St. Luke it is written, the kingdom of God is within man, not one man nor a group of men, but in all...
snake in the grass. Coming on in movie face. Coming on in movie face. And devil is at my door. Can't stall him, stay away.
Now you'll see a whole lot more. You Shut up. bed and your prayer won't be long. Listen and you'll hear the words through the old creation song.
Iowa dirt.
go. Well, this Iowa dirt is mighty cold, and God will never rest my soul down in this Iowa dirt so cold. Well, I'm digging my grave. Well, I'm digging my grave, and my road to hell.
Yard.
just a ghost with no words or name. I'm just a ghost with no heart. I'm just a ghost. Steady thread cutting hand, keep stealing ribbons from the steel and giving hell to every halyard you can. The storm that's surely coming along. If the sun was always shining in our Lord, I was like, we'd be shaking like a leaf with every God-given night. We'd break under the weight of any pressure that was ever applied. Be ready when the straw boss calls. He's got an ever-loving bone to pick with one and all. Don't let his condescension get you down. Just have the strength to know you're wrong, and when you're right, the strength to stand your ground.
To the crooked wits of tyrants when they call.
hear them all, I hear them all, I hear them all. I hear the sounds of tearing pages and the roar of burning paper. All the crimes and acquisition turn to air and ash and vapor. And the rattle of the shackle far beyond emancipated. And the lowliest to gather in their stalls. I hear them all, I hear them all, I hear them all. Dixie, with your money and your power, I can hear the flowers growing in the rubble of the towers. I hear leaders quit their lying, I hear babies quit their crying, I hear soldiers quit their dying, one and all. I hear them all, I hear them all, I hear them all. Gentle Lamb of Judah sleeping at the feet of Buddha.
should I go or should I stay on the outside?